Astronomy dear students, today the date is April 16, 2020. This is our lecture number 4 of week 1 and I am Afaq Ahmed. The topic which we are going to start today is chapter number 2, Patriotism. What are we going to study in patriotism is the comprehension, the first 3 paragraphs, reading, analyzing the text patterns and organization and arranging paragraph, comprehension questions, sentences at their types, simple sentence, complex sentence and compound complex sentence. First of all, the reading summary of paragraph number 1 is patriotism, love for the motherland and devotions to one's country. A patriot loves his country and is willing to sacrifice when the need arises. Origin of the word patriotism, Latin word patriota, which means countryman. In the summary of paragraph number 2 is, patriotism is the strength and source of courage for the countryman, the basic values on which a patriot will never compromise. Values like sovereignty, integrity and honor of the country. No patriot can compromise on these values. In paragraph number 3, we are going to discuss the role of Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah in building our country, Pakistan. Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, as the great patriot and his mission to protect the values of Muslims of subcontinent. Values like cultural, religious and social freedom. A sole essence of having a separate homeland and an own identity. Now, our next topic is sentence and its types. A sentence is the largest unit of any language. In English, it begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop, or a question mark, or an exclamation mark. He is a good boy, it's a statement. Is he a good boy? It's an interrogative question. And what a nice weather, exclaiming. For example, do it. In this sentence, a subject you is hidden, but verb do is visible. Types of sentence. There are 4 major types of sentences mainly, which are given below. Simple sentence, compound sentence, and compound complex sentence. What is a simple sentence? A simple sentence must have a single clause which is independent and it cannot make another clause. For example, I always wanted to become a writer. Compound sentence. A compound sentence must have more than one independent clause with no dependent clauses. Some specific conjunctions or punctuation or both are used to join together these clauses. Basically, compound sentence is the composition of 2 different clauses and one is independent and without having any dependent clause. I always wanted to become a writer and she wanted to become a doctor. 2 independent clauses, 2 different ideas or thinkings are joined together and no one is dependent on each other. Complex sentence. A complex sentence also has more than one clause, but one of them must be an independent clause and the other must be a dependent clause. There are also some particular connectors for the clauses of a complex sentence to be connected. I know that you always wanted to be a writer. Here, a dependent clause is followed by a connector and an independent clause. The other way around is also possible. Compound complex sentence. A compound complex sentence or complex compound sentence is a mixture of both features of compound and complex sentences in one sentence. So it must contain at least 2 independent clauses and at least 1 dependent clause. For example, I know that you always wanted to become a writer, but I always wanted to become a doctor. Here, one dependent clause is followed by a complex connector and 2 independent clauses with a compound conjunction between them. Now, it is time to assign you your home task. You are supposed to write sidebar questions on page number 13, give a brief reading, and find the answers by yourself. Find the difficult words from the chapter and find their meanings. Write down the glossary on page number 15 on your NEET registers. Thank you so much.